sports. What's going on, Paul?
All right, man, biggest game for in a long time for the Ravens on Monday night coming up. The Kansas City Chiefs coming to Baltimore to take on the Baltimore in prime time. All right, guys, trivia, piggybacking on.
Wait. Did you take a hit of boron gas? Does anyone else hear that?
Yeah.
Okay, Paul, you're as clear as a bell. There's not a list to be found.
Okay.
But you sound like you're talking like this. Hey, coming up on Monday night, it's the Chiefs versus the Ravens.
You sound like me when I'm doing the fat woman voice.
Wow. You want me?
No, I don't want you to change anything.
I'm trying to talk in a higher voice so it just sounds normal.
There's very few times in my life that somebody. So
this is the best word ever.
So what do you think about Kayvon Young not being a part of the squad? It's going to be Marlon Humphrey and who else?
I'm guessing this new system that we're doing, I'm going to have to diss every time and reestablish.
Okay. No, don't you dare. Don't you dare change a setting. You keep your hands up.
Hey, you know, he sounds like Herman Munster, if you guys can remember that.
Oh, my gosh, he does sound like Herman Munster. Oh, I got to find.
The late Fred Gwynn.
You also sound like the guy from Intervention that would just inhale duster.
What's up, bitch?
Yeah, you sound the guy that got high on a keyboard cleaner.
Open your eyes.
Maybe I should go somewhere and look for some helium, and that would solve the problem.
Yeah, no. No.
It tapers off at the end of the sentence.
Get
you guys notice that?
Boron.
It gets lower until the very end.
Boron gas is what you want to find. It does the opposite of what helium does. I want you Barry White deep.
He's close.
All right, so do you guys know when the Ravens played a home Monday night game, what year it was?
I don't.
No.
2017 was the Houston Texans. The Ravens won that game 23-16, and they'll play it again on Monday night. Now, the biggest key for the Ravens is to stop Patrick Mahomes and the Kansas City offense. Marcus Peters came to the Ravens in week 7, and him and Marlon Humphrey has become one of the best combinations of corners in the NFL. Let's hear from Marcus Peters and his relationship with Marlon Humphrey.
You're not going to hear anything until you sing for me, Paul Mittermeier. Take it away!
No.
Can't get enough of you, baby.
I'm gonna throw up. Jesus.
We feed off each other, man. You know, with us just going back and forth of talking ball, talking life, to be honest with you, things are just amazing, man. To get to know Marlon for the type of person he is and how hard he works. He's willing to take on any task and he's willing to do it 100%. So that's the best thing about for me. But yeah, we bounce thing questions off each other all the time.
Yeah. If you're just tuning in, we got Barry White on sports right now because I know that the Ravens are about to bury that foot in the Chiefs' ass.
All right, well, there you go.
You know, when Marcus Peters came to this team, he had a reputation, and it sounds like maybe it was a little unfair, as being kind of a clubhouse, I don't know if cancer is the right word, but not necessarily a great locker room guy. And when he's come to the Ravens, it seems not just was that wrong, but it's the exact opposite. You know, people love him, and he's made friends all throughout, and he seems to be just a great teammate. I don't know if he changed the way that he behaved or if he just had a reputation he didn't deserve, but we didn't get the guy that we were purported to be getting.
Okay, well, here's a couple of things. I'm glad you brought that up, Joe, because Ryan Wright is going to talk about this.
Yeah,
I can even feel it's going to talk.
More and more ways. That's super world of my home. Nobody but you and me.
You're right. Nobody but you and me are going to be enjoying watching Lamar do everything that he's got to do this this coming Monday on the flagship station.
What were you going to say, Paul?
So he was just talking, no. Joe. Did you not hear him? He's talking about what Lamar means to him. Listen. I mean, God, Joe, get the wax out of your ears, brother.
What do you prefer, the Lisp or the Barry White?
The Barry White, if you, I swear to God, Paul, I will make a call to New York to cost you your job if you do anything to fix your settings. This is the way you sound from now on.
How did this happen?
If you don't make any changes.
Not
to
a
that.
One.
You got a new image.
All right. It's the second chapter of Mittermeier. People are dying online right now. People say, oh, my God, I just crashed my car laughing. No, you didn't. But I believe they might have this morning. You were saying Paul White.
He sounds like an overnight guy. Maybe he's got a new career ahead of him.
Oh, my God. I want to hear you front sell Nirvana.
Dude, my cell phone is blowing up. It's texting me saying how great this is.
Misha says she is on the ground in tears right now. She cannot. Katie Robinson is belly laughing at Paul. Holy hell. I have never laughed this effing hard. I am in tears. Paul sounds like he wants to. Yes, Paul, you sound like the guy in the Mafia documentary who's behind the veil of darkness.
I remember the first time we killed an informant. We used a pickaxe.
Joe, to your point, he started with the Chiefs. You know, I'm trying.
No,
it's never going to happen.
Be a pro.
Started with the Chiefs. Okay.
Started with the Chiefs, was drafted by the Chiefs, and then came to Baltimore. I truly think after being around Marcus Peters, here's my take on the whole thing. He's just that tells it like it is. And he says stuff that you don't want to hear, but he tells it to you anyway. And a lot of times the wrong way. But as a player, this guy is either the best or one of the best corners. Smart. He's aggressive. He makes plays. He's got 28 career interceptions. He's got 6 interception and 7 touchdowns overall as a defensive player. He's just a great football player and team any day.
Didn't hear a word.
Yeah, baby. The Ravens gonna get up in that ass on Monday. Yeah, what are they gonna do, Paul? What are they gonna do? Oh, talk to me, baby.
Oh, baby.
Paul, where do you watch the game?
Watching from the stats booth.
He watches it from that red heart-shaped velvet bed.
It's gonna be weird watching the game with no fans again on Monday night.
Oh, there's gonna be a fan laying beside you in bed, freshly sexed up, sipping on a Rianiti. Paul, what's coming up at 8:35?
Oh, just more.
Oh, no.
Oh, no, he lost Paul.
Oh, what if it fixed itself?
I don't want him to change the deep voice, and if that means him cutting in and out, I don't care.
It's a trade-off I'm willing to accept. I am 100% with Josh. If it takes me missing every 10th word he says, that's a price I'm willing to pay to hear him sound exactly like a one-legged Barry White. Oh, my God. Okay, that's Stumbles White with news, sports. Jesus, that might be one of the funniest things that's happened all year long.
There are lots of ways to listen to 98 Rock every day. 97.9 FM, streaming live on 98online.com. The 98 Rock smartphone app on iPhone and Android, and on your Amazon Alexa and Google Home. Make sure to follow us on Facebook at facebook.com/98online.